Hello everyone, and welcome to the Minecraft Transit Railway Tutorials. In this episode, we will talk about building escalators and adding our own custom content through resource packs. In the comments of the past few videos, a lot of you requested a tutorial on how to create escalators. They can be a bit tricky to build, so we're going to cover escalators in this video, even though it was not in the original plan. The easiest way to create an escalator is to build a stairway with temporary blocks as shown. Make sure that there is enough space at the top and bottom to create a flat landing. Next, we need to make sure that we're facing in the same direction as if we're going up the stairs, then place down escalator pieces one by one. We can right-click the escalator steps with a brush to change the direction of movement. If any of the pieces do not update properly, we can also right-click the escalator steps. We can optionally remove the temporary blocks as well. Escalators do not always have to go up or down. They can be made into travellators, which are commonly seen in large airports. Simply mark out an area where the travellator will be, and place down escalator pieces as shown. We can also right-click the steps to change the direction of movement. Practice building escalators of different lengths. They can make stations more appealing and easier to navigate. Next, we will talk about adding custom content to the game. At the time of this video's release, the mod only supports retexturing existing trains and adding custom sign tiles, although this might change in the future. It is highly recommended to be familiar with creating Minecraft resource packs before continuing. First, let's make a directory and add the required folders for the MTR namespace. We will need to make a JSON file called mtr_custom_resources.json. This is the file where we register our texture variants for existing trains or new sign tiles. For this tutorial, we will make a black and white SP1900 train. We will need a JSON object called custom_trains and then another JSON object with these four tags. The second JSON object should be a unique key, for example, black and white SP1900. The name and color fields will determine what will show up on the railway dashboard when selecting trains for a siding. The base train type is what train type our train is based on, in this case, SP1900. We can find all the different train IDs on the wiki as well. Finally, the texture ID is the namespace identifier of our texture file. For example, if we put our texture, called custom_sp1900.png, into a folder called custom_directory, our namespace ID will be written as shown. We can use a JSON validator to verify that our JSON file is formatted correctly. The link to this validator is in the description. Let's zip up our resource pack and test it. Don't forget to create other required files inside the resource pack, such as pack.mcmeta. Refer to the official Minecraft wiki for more details. Let's create a siding and depot to test out the new train. Note that when the train type of a siding is changed, existing trains already in the world will no longer reflect the change. Instead, click on the Clear Trains button in the depot screen to remove the existing trains and to force the siding to spawn new ones. Congratulations! We have added a custom texture into the game. The original SP1900 train is still available, so we can use both the default SP1900 texture and our new texture at the same time. Now, we will talk about adding our own sign tiles for railway signs. We have talked about railway signs in the last tutorial, so feel free to go back to that video if necessary. For this tutorial, we will make three happy face signs, one with no text, one with custom text to the right, and one with custom text to the left. First, we will need a JSON object called custom_signs, and then more JSON objects with tags. These JSON objects should have unique keys. Let's call the first one happy_face. There are more keys for custom signs than custom train textures, but not all of them are required. The texture ID is the namespace identifier of the texture file, just like before. This is the only required field, and everything else is optional. For our second and third signs, we will use more keys. The flip_texture key will determine if the sign should be flipped horizontally. For example, we could turn a left arrow into a right arrow. The custom text field determines what text would be shown to the right of the sign tile. The flip custom text field requires that the custom text field is set. If this is true, the text will be shown to the left of the sign tile instead of the right. The small field will determine if the image will have a margin around it. Let's put margins around all three of our signs. Finally, the background color field can be used to override the background color of the sign. It requires an RGB hex code, and the sign will default to a black background if no custom background color is specified. Let's update our resource pack and see it in game. When we right-click the railway sign with a brush, the custom sign should appear. Congratulations, we have added some custom signs into the game. An example resource pack, slightly different from the content in this tutorial, is available on the Minecraft Transit Railway wiki. The link for it is also in the description below. Thank you everyone for watching this episode of the Minecraft Transit Railway tutorials. Today, we learned how to build escalators and add our own content into the game. We added a new SP1900 texture and a few new sign tiles for the railway signs. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please remember to like this video and subscribe to the channel, and comment down below if you have any questions for me. Please also let me know what you would like to see in the next video. I have put some useful links down in the description, so be sure to check that out. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.